assistance from the umpire. And I'll tell you what, this is going to be a fascinating encounter. Ma Lin, one of the most fearsome players in the world, and there Wang Lichin, more quiet, really quite a shy persona, very popular with his teammates. But these two players have played such sensational table tennis at this 2005 World Championships. It's very difficult to pick a winner. On the one occasion that Ma Lin did make the final of the World Championships back in 1999, he lost 24-22 in the fifth. That was back in the days when table tennis was up to 21. That's Wang Lichin, the world number one. And en route, a couple of scares, particularly against Li Qing of Hong Kong in the last 16. But earlier today we saw him defeat Oh Sang-un and he looked imperious, 4-1. Wang Lichin deploying the shake hands technique. There Ma Lin gripping the bat between index finger and thumb. And there we see his route to the final. He struggled against Peter Corbell of the Czech Republic. He won 11-9 in the seventh, but since then it's been relatively plain sailing. Blachik 4-0. Lu Gusheng, his compatriot, 4-2. And then a victory against the comeback kid, Michael Mays, 4-0 in the semi-final. So the formality of the warm-up about to be complete. So the final of the men's singles at the 2005 World Championships. Wang Lichin, the world number one in red, against Ma Lin, the world number two in blue. Just coming to the end of the 2-minute warm-up. And we're looking forward to what could be an absorbing contest between, without doubt really, the two outstanding male players in world table tennis. Both players with power, technique, drive, and plenty of guile. We've got a clash of styles. Ma Lin, the pen holder. Wang Lichin, the shake hands player. And an intake of breath. Can Wang Lichin take a second world title? Can Ma Lin win his first? Lichin to serve at the beginning of the first game. And as always, the opening exchanges will be vital. That's going to be a shot that will be very important for Ma Lin. The swivel-wristed backhand on the diagonal, because Wang Lichin is going to try and make him play backhands from the backhand side of the table. Around blind, anticipated the backhand on the diagonal, and he was round like a flash to execute that forehand counter topspin. Intricate exchange over the table, touch to touch. Wang Lichin took the initiative. 6 points played, 3 apiece. Smalling at his best. Adam Sharara, the president of the International Table Tennis Federation, looking on approvingly. Beautifully executed forehand. The player in blue, undoubtedly the fastest forehand on the planet. Let's serve. Great recovery from Marlin, then the counter topspin. And he started off like a steam train. He exudes ambition from every pore. One of the hardest working players in the practice hall, Marlin in blue. And he was so bitterly disappointed to have narrowly missed out on the world title in 99. I tell you what, he's not going to have it his own way. The world number one, Wang Lichin, has also started off very well. And the atmosphere, absolutely electric. The audience knows that they're going to have a China winner whatever happens, but they're lifting the roof. The key to the success of the penholder player in recent years, that innovation just deployed by Marlin, the swivel wristed backhand. Great switch from Wang Lichin. One of the skills that you have to perfect to be a top table tennis player, using the peripheral vision to notice when one's opponent is trying to step around. Play from Wang Lichin again. The flick and then stepped in, took it at the top of the bounce. No time for Marlin in which to react. Well, both players are thinking strategically despite the pressure. This time Marlin's turn to use the backhand parallel into the open space. This is going to be a fascinating battle of tactics and will. Lichin, 8-all. Well, he changed his mind. Thought about taking with the forehand, changed his mind at the last instant. A bit of hesitancy there. Two loose mistakes from Marlin has handed Lichin two game points. Place you don't want to be against Marlin is away from the table. One game point saved, one remaining. Big point at the end of this, the opening game of the men's singles final. Oh, wonderful shot on the diagonal by Wang Lichin. He takes the first game 11-9. He was trailing throughout the opening game, but came back in and came back well. And he played the bigger shots better when it mattered. Marlin, the swivel-wristed backhand, but eventually outmaneuvered. So it is Wang Lichin who takes the opening game, 11-9. Into the second game, Marlin leading one love. Marlin showing why he's one of the most fearsome players in world table tennis. He's equally adept in the touch exchanges as he is in open play. Unforced error. First we've seen from Wang Lichin in this final. The ball was high and it was mid-table. Great footwork from Marlin. Wang Lichin engaging him backhand to backhand, but he stepped around blind. The anticipation paid off. Goodness me, the technique on that forehand, picture perfect. Great weight transfer, rotation from the hips, and now a 5-love start for Marlin. Just what he needed. Awesome. What a turnaround. Wang Lichin taking the opening game 11-9, and in the second he's lost 7 in succession. And Marlin is flying. I think if Wang Lichin can continue playing the backhand with that kind of conviction and that kind of pace, he's a slight favourite for this final. There we see it again. Oh, but Marlin was equal to it. Virtually no time to prepare the racket head for that counter topspin. No backswing, or minimal backswing. But he's inching closer to the second game. Wonderful serve for Marlin, then the drop shot. Oh, and he's got it back, Wang Lichin. But the winner, the hooked forehand. Great table tennis. So there it is, the second game to Marlin, 11-3. And this best of seven men's singles final now stands at one game all. Real change around there. Wang Lichin looking very good in the opening game, but Marlin utterly dominant, taking the second, 11-3. So a 1-minute break between games. China against China, so the coaches have gone up into the tribune and they've left the players to their own devices. It will be the players who decide when they want to take the respective timeouts, and it will be the players who determine the tactical strategy. They know each other so well. Wang the Chin in red, serving at the beginning of the third game, and it is one game apiece. He looked at his bat, Wang the Chin, but it was the power on that Marlin topspin that was the difference. Well, he can hardly believe it. Wang the Chin suddenly looking just a tad nervous. There's a high chop block for Marlin. He stepped in, took it at the top of the bounce, but he misread the quantity of spin and it went long. Two love. Well, if there is a question mark against that man, Wang the Chin, it's about his mental vulnerability. We've seen him lose in pressurised situations before, not least against Werner Schlager 2 years ago at the World Championships in Paris, when he led 3-2 and 10-6. And suddenly, this is all Marlin. He went 7-love up in game two. He's dominating in game three. And Wang the Chin, uncharacteristically, has made a succession of unforced errors. And again, no doubt about it, only one word to describe the transformation in the form of this man. He's choking. Wang the Chin has got to recover his composure, or he's going to go down, and he's going to go down badly. Oh, that was a good serve for Marlin. Let service. That was loaded with reverse side spin. Could almost hear the ball whistling as it travelled over the net. Wonderful return. That's what he needs to do. He's got to reassert himself in this final. Great flick down the line by Wang the Chin. He still trails, however. Two serves to come. Remarkable. It was a good side and top serve, created the opportunity that he wanted. Somehow he's missed that forehand topspin, and that's why Marlin leads 8-2. Wang the Chin making unforced errors. This time he's outplayed though. The depth on that Marlin topspin from the deep, that was the key on the white line. Here we see it. First the opener, then that powerful counter topspin, and again. Well, think Wang Lichin possibly has resigned himself to going 2-1 behind. It's a long way back in this third game, but he's talking to himself, he's G-ing himself up. A tactic that you feel Wang Lichin needs to deploy. He's got to engage Marlin on the backhand side, force him to play backhands. And that is where Wang Lichin has his strength. He hasn't managed to assert himself though in this third game until now. Oh, it's topspin, topspin, and this time Wang Lichin winning out. So I think I spoke prematurely when I said he'd resigned himself to losing the third game, because he's in with a chance. If he can take this point, he'll be 2 behind with his own 2 serves to come. He's given himself a lifeline. Oh, good recovery from Wang Lichin. Marlin exploding into the ball, travels at over 100 miles per hour, only 0.06 of a second, and Wang Lichin to get that on ball, played on instinct. And the noise level in this auditorium is ratcheting up. 7-9. Oh, this is incredible. He's come back from nowhere, and I wonder if Marlin will take a timeout. The momentum has shifted dramatically in this third game. A rueful grin. Key moments in this men's singles final. Oh, that's the shot of the match so far for Marlin. Wang Lichin went for broke. Marlin guessed right. He had shaped the racket head even as the ball was crossing the net. And that was steely resilience from the world number 2. Being put under severe pressure from Wang Lichin in the game that we thought was all over. And it is Marlin now. Game points on his own serve. And he's done it. Marlin takes the third game, 11-8. It was a brave fight back from Wang Lichin. He put his compatriot under severe pressure, but Marlin equal to the test. Great table tennis. And it is Marlin who moves into a 2-game advantage. He's taken 2 games on the trot. And there we see the story of the match so far. Marlin leading Wang Lichin 2-1. Beginning of the fourth game, Marlin leading 2-1 with the serve. The faster start in games 2-3 and now once again in game 4. Wang Lichin is under pressure yet again. For Marlin. positioned himself majestically. Great weight transfer, perfect technique, a 3-1 lead. And Wang the Chin hits back. The quality of the table tennis has increased at the beginning of this fourth game. So little time to prepare the racket head, Wang the Chin. Short backswing, fast follow through. And these players will know each other's game so well. They train together in the National Centre on the outskirts of Beijing. A huge complex of buildings has churned out players with an almost miraculous rate over the last 3 to 4 decades. When Marlin's getting in first with the forehand topspin, by and large he's winning the point. Let's service. Hesitant again. An easy shot to play. The ball had just dropped below the height of the net. Wang Lichin had to get a lot of rotation to create the dip. And he's 2 points down now in game number 4. Marlin looking good. Heavy underspin. Dragging the Wang Lichin forehand into the net. But the chin's dropped off yet again. He's got to play at or near his best level if he's going to beat this player, Marlin. He's just not producing the goods. It's become slightly scrappy after a very good start in this fourth game. And I don't doubt that the pressure, to a certain extent, is getting to Wang the Chin in red. Lost a number of highly pressurised matches over the last 4 to 5 years. Marlin, 7-5, high toss serve. Another unforced error from the racket of Wang Lichin. Not always the better player who wins a world championship final, it's the stronger player. Feeling is that Wang Lichin needs to win this game. I don't see him coming back from 3-1 behind. Crucial points. Oh, and he's missed again. The counter topspin was sublime, but when he had a bit of time to think about it, he just decelerated through the ball. No conviction with that forehand, and he's looking frail. Hate to say it. But Wang Lichin in red, the world number one, looking decidedly vulnerable. Slowed it down. And then that backhand down the line. Marlin, two serves to come. Just indicating to the umpire that he wants to take his time out. Well, that surprises me. Wang Lichin had won just a solitary point. He wasn't into a run of points. And suddenly Marlin decided to take a timeout. Now, is that an indication that he feels now is a crux moment in this men's singles final? Didn't seem to be under pressure. Wang Lichin was the one who was evidencing severe anxiety, but it's a player in blue with his serves to come. Perhaps he just wanted to have a chance to reflect upon what might be the right choice of service. See there, Marlin, having dropped the opening game, took the second 11-3, the third 11-8, and he's in a possession of dominance in game number four. How will that timeout affect the momentum? Good play from Wang Lichin. He pinned Marlin down the backhand side. I can't help thinking that Marlin's decision to take a timeout has been seen by Wang Lichin as a possible sign of weakness. Will that encourage the man in red? He's looked hesitant ever since he took that opening game. Another big point. Marlin serving 9-8 now. Yes! Wang Lichin's taken two in a row after the timeout, three in total. And now this fourth crucial game, evenly poised at 9 points all. The dignitaries enjoying it as much as the fans. We've created such a terrific atmosphere throughout the duration of the 2005 World Championships. Here we are with the climax, the men's singles final. And key moments, Wang Lichin, 9-all. Great block from Wang Lichin. Marlin, who looked to be sailing through this final, suddenly faces a game point, and Wang Lichin could be at 2-all. I've said it before, I'll say it again. Marlin made a mistake taking a timeout at 9-7. Can Lichin close it out? What a rally to finish it off. Wang Lichin takes the fourth game, 11-9. And yet again at the 2005 World Championships, we have seen a dramatic change in momentum. Wang Lichin, it looked to be almost all over. But that timeout from Marlin handed the player in red a lifeline. And look at that celebration. The men's singles final locked together. It's two games all. So what next? Marlin already back to the table. He can scarcely believe what's just happened. He looked to have that fourth game in the palm of his hand and inexplicably took his time out at 9-7. And I just saw in the expression of Wang Lichin that he felt suddenly that his opponent was rather more nervous than he thought. And he pounced. Two games apiece, best of 7 up to 11. Wang Lichin, the world number one serving. At the beginning of the fifth game. Well, it's difficult to pick a winner now. It's a question of nerve. Both these players want to win this match, and they want it desperately. But it's a question of who can hold himself together better for longer. The tactics are clear. Marlin going for the chop block. This time it didn't work. And suddenly it is Wang the Chin with a spring in his step, bouncing. Suddenly exuding confidence. Well, Ma Lin started off like a steam train in games 2, 3 and 4. Wang Luchin has established a 3-point advantage. Top spin from Ma Lin. The high toss serve deployed by Ma. The ball accelerating down, facilitating heavier spin. Slightly more difficult to control. Three in a row. The speed of Wang Luchin to get round, prodigious. That was too strong. Ma Lin decided before the point, I think, that he was going to go for broke. Huge forehand. Recovered beautifully to take the second one off the bounce on the half volley. And Wang Luchin did well. He got the right direction, but just a tad long. It was an open table. That block had gone on. Ma Lin was nowhere. Wonderful shot. Almost a carbon copy of the last point, except this time Wang Luchin blocking it on the table, down the line for the winner. Locked together once again. Two games all, 6 points all in the fifth. The world number one, two serves to come. Well, it's a tactic he's deploying. Great advantage, that backhand block down the line. Marlin stepping around, looking to play the forehand from the backhand side. And Wang Luchin thinking tactically and showing great composure. Oh, Oh, great rally. He's got Marlin away from the tape. He'll stick down the back. Oh, he switched it down the forehand. He saw that Marlin was itching to get around and play that forehand from the wide backhand. And that's why he took a risk, switched it into the forehand side. Great play from Wang Lichin. It's Marlin in blue, the world number two, under pressure again. Wonderful. Geometrically superb. Marlin comprehensively outmaneuvered Wang Lichin now, 2 points away from taking a 3-2 lead. Who would have believed that midway through the fourth? Marlin fires back. Well, he got his way back into the rally. He predicted and anticipated the Marlin drop shot. He'll be disappointed. He had a chance with that forehand. Both players prowling around the court. Wang Lichin still with an advantage. Second serve in this sequence of two. Yet another key point. Well, the last game was determined by a 2-point margin. This is going to be a second successive game. Marlin with the advantage now. That was a hesitant backhand by Wang Lichin. A good 6 inches long. Whoever wins this game will be just one game away from being the 2005 world champion. Great counter topspin from Wang Lichin. He's outmatching Marlin on his favoured diagonal. The depth on that forehand from Lichin, quite superb. And for a player who's considered to be mentally suspect, he's produced the goods when it mattered at the end of game four. Can he close out game five? 9-10. Oh, great block from Lichin, and he's got it back! Oh, magnificent table tennis. Oh, you can't believe it. Wang Lichin, fist in the air. What a point to end off that fifth game. The world number one has taken it 11-9. And this capacity audience has brought the roof off the stadium. One of the rallies of the championships. And what a time to produce it for Wang Lichin. Both players producing superb table tennis. This is wonderful play for the neutral. When you consider the ball travelling over 100 miles per hour, phenomenal. And he deserves those celebrations. Dramatic end to the fifth game. Wang Lichin, the former champion, one game away from victory. Goodness me. I wonder what he's thinking. 3-2 for Wang Lichin. Well, the players back for the beginning of the sixth game. I think the rest of us need to get our breath back. The atmosphere, electric. Biggest competition of 2005, the biannual World Championships. Wang Lichin to serve, trailing 3-2. What a start for Wang Lichen. A game that he needs to become the champ. They're on to a winner, really. It's going to be a Chinese champion, whatever happens, and they're going to complete a clean sweep of all five events at the 2005 World Championship. But this is a monumental struggle and a fitting climax to what has been a great competition. And the table tennis is getting better and better. Desire and ambition etched upon the countenance of Ma Lin. He's been in this position before. He lost a narrow, dramatic final 4 years ago. Breathtaking. He's dug deep. He looked to have handed the match to his opponent midway through game four. He snuck it out 11-9, took the fifth by the same margin. I just wonder what Ma Lin still has in the tank. They've been battling hard now for 6 days. Fitness is going to play its part towards the end of this match. Well, it's relentless topspinning from Wang Lichen. Once he gets the initiative, he's not letting go. The recovery is the key. Once he's played the shot, he's getting back into position to keep the pressure on Ma Lin. What a time to produce a forehand like that. The length of shot, the transfer of the weight, the technique, absolutely perfect. But he's in big trouble, the world number two. Great direction. He's still thinking clearly despite the pressure. He had noticed that Wang Lichen was trying to step around. Delivered the ball down the line into the empty space for the winner. Oh, that's magnificent from Wang Lichen. All the doubts, all the anxiety has been extinguished. Exuding confidence and self-belief. A 3-point margin. Ma Lin has already taken his time out. This match in the hands of the world number one. And as soon as I say that, what does he do? A shot of hesitancy for Wang Lichen. The ball was long, didn't need to push it. Are there going to be any more twists in what has been a thoroughly absorbing narrative and a great final? Heavy underspin dragging the Lichen return into the net. He's clinging on by his fingernails, Ma Lin. got himself back into the sixth game. Well, they've been treated to an absolute feast of table tennis. One of the best matches at the 2005 World Championships, but there have been so many. It's been a fitting climax to a great event. Wang Lichin, two serves to come. Yeah, that's a good forehand. The reverse side's been set it up. And now 2 points away from becoming one of the few players in history to win the world men's singles title twice. Victor Barna did it. Bergman, Leach, Jan Ove Waldner, Jiang Jiliang. Oh, this is unbelievable. Marlin with the switch, and it's a smash. Oh, and he smashed it out of the ground. Under severe pressure, Marlin responding with some blistering table tennis. Well, neither of these players can hear themselves think. They probably can hardly hear the bounce of the ball on the table. Absolute pandemonium. And there it is. Wang Lichin. Is he about to justify his number one seeding? He is on the threshold of a second world title. Championship point. You got a feel for that man. He's been so close so often. But he's a nearly man once more. Wang Lichin takes a six-game 11-7. And he becomes the 2005 world champion. He acknowledges the adoration of this capacity crowd in Shanghai. What a performance. Halfway through that fourth game, it looked all over. But Wang Lichin, he had to dig deep, and he had to demonstrate the steely resilience of a world champion. He's got a feel for Marlin. He was so close in 1999. He lost 23-21 in the fifth to Liu Guliang, and he's lost another epic final here. Wang Lichin, exhausted and emotional. He is the world champion of 2005, coming through against Ma Lin by 4-2. And a performance will be covered as well. Really has been a magnificent World Championships here in Shanghai 2005. A succession of wonderful matches. Perhaps Michael Mays against Hao Shui the pick, that men's singles quarterfinal. But Wang Lichin against Marlin, another devastating demonstration of rapid fire table tennis. That last point in the fifth game, well, that will remain with me for many years to come. And great congratulations for Wang Lichin. He's one of the nicest guys in world table tennis. Very shy, very demure, a real gentleman. And some have often questioned whether he has a killer instinct, but didn't he demonstrate it there? Table tennis, a national sport here in China, and Wang Lichin fast becoming a national hero. Hope you've enjoyed it as much as I have. Wang Lichin's the champion, but for now, for me, Matthew Side, a very good afternoon.